Hello friends, today we are going to see the demo on Snowflake Snowsight. This feature is still in preview and not yet released, but today we can have a quick tour of Snowsight and we would see like what is Snowsight and what makes it different from a normal worksheet. Guys, if you have not seen my blog on Snowflake Snowsight, a hype or a real deal, I would suggest to go ahead and read my blog. I have tried to put lots of insights in my blog for Snowsight. Let's move to a demo. Let me log into my account, Snowflake. I have enabled MFA, so let me just approve my login. It is taking time. Okay, all right. So this is my classic web UI. To go into Snowsight, we have to click on Preview App. I have to sign in for the first time. Have to approve my MFA. So this is my landing page. You will land to the worksheet tab. So here it's a new look of entire Snowsight web UI. So basically Snowsight is nothing, just an enhanced version, or you can say as a better version of a worksheet which we already have here. Here on the left side, you can see the navigation where you have the worksheet where you can write the query, dashboard where you can have the visualization. There is a data tab where you can see all your schemas, marketplace, monitor where you can see all your resource monitors. Admin is the place where you can put your filters, custom filters. So we will talk about this more on later. Let's go to the worksheet. So I will open my dashboard query. So I have kept some query pre-handed so that I will not waste much time on the query. So let's go and execute this query first. So if to execute, I have to select the query and click on the run. So on the left hand side, you can see like it gives the automatic stats. It gives me how many order row count and all the details. If you want to see the schema, you have to first select, you can also select the database. And the schema you want to select from here. And when you click on schema, it will give you the table list. Here you can find the table. Once you want to see the table detail, you can pin them. The moment you click, it will get pinned. If you want to unpin, you can click here. It will go away. If you click on preview, it will give you a few records as a sample record to see what kind of data you see. You can see on the table. So it's taking time. But it will load a sample data for you. Yep. Yep. Another cool feature is like, here you can on the fly like you can change the or you can resize the warehouse, so you can make the status as resume. You can change the size of your existing warehouse from here only. You can also change the scaling policy. Another feature is like you can see the history from here. So if you go here, what I have written on 10:15, so it's keep on appending the history of the query. You can also share the query. So say, suppose I want to share this query with one of my friends. I will go here and click here and say get link. So the person who has this link can see the query if he has the same role like sysadmin. As of now, I have sysadmin. So the person, if they have also sysadmin role on the same database, they can see the query. Alright. So let's go on dashboard and let's see quickly what is dashboard. So when you go on dashboard, you have to click on the plus sign and name your dashboard. So I will write Rajiv's dashboard and say click dashboard. To add the tiles, you have to click on new tiles and then you have to give the query for your tiles. So okay, let me quickly go to my worksheet dashboard query. Let me grab this query. So I will add a new query here. Let me execute this. Alright, I have data now. So I will go on chart. I will change this to bar chart. Or I will go to this to get a heat. Alright. So when I click on this, it will go and add the chart on the dashboard. Let me do one thing I forgot. Let's name this as a order status. Then, so whatever name you will put to your query, it will come as a heading. Okay. Go ahead and add new tile. So I will just make the count. Let me execute this. All right. I will go and make that as a scorecard and rename this as a order total. Go ahead and add this on here. So we'll go ahead and create a new one as well and see. I will add all the data. Order data. Let me cancel this. Let me limit this to 100. All right. Let me put that on the sheet. Here is our visualization. So you can see in very simple steps, I have created a dashboard and it is giving me an own insight on the tip of my finger. So that's the beauty of SnowSight, that with a small time, if you don't have that much time, you don't have to go and dig deeper into the BI tools, and with an expertise on SQL, you can create your own dashboard for your quick things. Yes, but for the more enhanced, more complex dashboard, you have to go to the BI. But for the simple one, you can do it on your own. Let's move back to. So guys, if you have not subscribed, please subscribe, like, and share to my channel.